the Queen's New Year gift list that survives for the year 1579, the name of Philip Sidney is found at the very bottom, reflecting a loss of favor for this young, promising courtier, brought about by his writing to her personally to protest her proposed marriage to the French Duke of Alençon. And Sidney's having offended the powerful Earl of Oxford in an incident on the tennis court. He retired for a time to his sister's estate in Wilton and devoted his time to writing poems, some of which were set to music.
Thank you. jeweled whip, symbolic of his self-penitence and his submission to her will. She eventually appointed him Master of the Ordnance, responsible for fortifying the ports against the Spanish. He was knighted in 1582, and in 1585, he was sent as governor of Flushing to the Netherlands. In September 1586, a convoy of Spanish provisions was making its way toward the town of Zutphen, and a hasty plan was devised to intercept it, led by the Earl of Essex, Sir Philip Sidney, and a man described by Sidney as my very friend, and indeed a valiant and frank gentleman, Peregrine Bertie, Lord Willoughby. Lord Willoughby pressed far into the enemy lines, and while rescuing him from capture, Sidney received a musket shot to his left thigh. He insisted on riding away on his one horse, wounded though he was, so that, quote, the foe shall miss the glory of my wound. He died 26 days later. Philip Sidney was a true model of worth. Like Zephyrus, he gave life where he blew. The universities abroad and at home accounted him a general of learning. Soldiers honored him. There was not a cunning painter, skillful engineer, excellent musician that made not himself known to this famous spirit and found him his true friend and the common rendezvous of worth in his time.